So a study by Girard and Company in 2018 was looking at another example of how young children interpret silent or implied subjects. So in this case, we have Dora washed Diego before eating a red apple. So here's your non-finite embedded clause. So there's no tense associated with this. Right? It's not will or did, right? It's just eating. And you have your two potential implied subjects, Dora, who's this girl right here, and Diego, right? So Dora washed Diego before eating a red apple, so you have the washing event. And then the question is, well, who ate the red apple? Who is the implied subject of eating a red apple, right? And so, you know, that's really the question here. And the way that they got a participant's knowledge was to ask participants to color the appropriate apple red. So if they color Dora's apple red, they think she's the implied subject. If they color Diego's apple red, they think he's the implied subject, right? So what do adults do? Well, adults all color Dora's apple red because they think Dora is the implied subject. Dora washed Diego before eating a red apple. Dora's the one eating a red apple, right? It turns out that 4 and 5 year olds do this too. Actually, children age 4 mostly, you know, also color Dora's apple red, thinking that Dora is the silent subject of eating a red apple. But interestingly, if you place them in a more cognitively demanding environment where their attention, they're distracted, there's other things going on, well then 4 and 5 year olds behave as if they think Diego is the one who's the silent subject. Diego is the one eating a red apple, right? So what we take from this is that young children may have adult-like knowledge of how to interpret implied subjects in a less cognitively demanding environment. They behave like adults and think Dora is the one eating the apple, that she is the implied subject. But it seems like in more cognitively demanding environments, they can't deploy that knowledge as effectively, right? And so they kind of default to a, you know, sort of the closest implied subject potentially, which is Diego in this case, which of course is not the way adults actually interpret this. So what we can take away from this is that development in this case seems to involve developing processing abilities, the ability to sort of deploy the knowledge that you have, not really developing the knowledge itself, because if in a less cognitively demanding environment, the children seem to have the adult-like knowledge of how to interpret these implied subjects. It's just that when things get distracting, they can't deploy that knowledge as effectively.